Would you face the flames of a human incinerator for your faith?
Renounce him! What's wrong with you?
That boy needs Jesus. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Avocast Studios. I'm your host, Jake, Sir Stormchild, whatever. When I say that I'm an absurdist, I mean that in more of a literal sense, whereas, you know, looking for God and trying to find him is kind of pointless because you could prove him either way. And also, it makes no difference in my life. I'm not saying if it makes any difference for you, that's awesome. Believers are going to believe whether you tell them you're stupid or not. I'm not calling you stupid. I'm just saying that's the argument. I come from the South and a very religious household. This was given to me before I went into the military. But wait, there's more. That's just a King James Bible. Hold on. Which version you want to talk about, huh? The Magic Shield by Francis Melville. This one just describes a bunch of like different kinds of religions and really opened my eyes. Also, I kind of like the plushness of the cover. This is the Book of Mormon, or as I like to call it, the Book of And. And then that, and then this happened, and then this happened, and then this happened. It's very, very boring. It's also like the third part of the Bible. It's kind of like Godfather Part 3. It's like, we don't need this. This is a copy of the Necronomicon. It's very confusing and honestly not well written, but also it's meant to be confusing. So, you know, whatever. This is the Bible I've had for a very long time, the New Adventure Bible. It's very flashy and very crazy. It's very 90s, I should say. The Student's Life Application Bible. By the way, did I mention that I went to Bible camp and all that whatnot? Well, except for like Bible camp for me was like my grandma just dropping me off at a church for like an afternoon, which I found very strange and awkward and boring for the most part. And also the Children's Bible, which is illustrated, and it's falling apart, so I'm not going to open it, but it's honestly kind of nice. Also, hold on, I wasn't done. Here's more stuff. This is more than a carpenter. This is an argument for why Jesus is real. This is more than a carpenter that my grandma just gave me again. This is also referenced within that same book for some reason about a homicide investigator who went, ooh, got it in the details. It's like, no, it's got it in the gaps and he misses out on the entire point. Like I said, you can make an argument for basically anything. The South was right. Now, my grandma and I used to go to a lot of museums and I bought this because I actually did want to read it. And then now I just kind of have it here. And I'm not going to read this piece of shit. South was right. I'm not going to defend that. I grew up reading this, the first dictionary of cultural literacy. It's very broad and it was given to me by my atheistic aunt. This is the bigger version of it, which I think was actually for my grandmother's grandmother. But it's the very thick version of that version. Also, I have a deck of tarot cards and a rosary that I found for some reason. It was in a vehicle and I just thought it'd be a shame to throw it away. But at that point, I was more religious or more spiritual and whatnot. I know you're like, hey, isn't this supposed to be a review of a movie? Yes, it is. We'll get to that. I just needed to explain myself for that. I'm not coming at Christians telling you what to do. And also to explain myself like who I am and, you know, like why I say I'm an absurdist. It's more like there's no real reason to argue about whether God is real or not, because his belief in you and you, your belief in him is kind of just pointless. And at the end of things, I've had arguments with preachers, priests, and now it's just like I go to, you know, some family gathering. They're like, we're going to bow our heads and pray. I'm just like, all right, as long as I can eat afterwards, I'll say amen. I don't give a shit. There are many, many other channels that do this better at trying to argue the position.
That it is the inalienable right of every man or woman to rid himself
or herself.
Agreed.
Thank you, brother.
Or sister.
Where was I?
I think you finished.
Oh.
Let's get into a movie that I got. Revelation. This movie is technically a sequel to another movie. It's by the producers or the people who did like Left Behind, which is Jack Van Impe and John Hagee.
And he'll try to let the world know that he is the promised Messiah, the Prince of Peace of Isaiah 9:6.
Another thing is like I grew up in Methodists, Baptists, Episcopalians, all kinds of like different denominations. I've been to like singing churches, solemn churches. There was no like signs churches where people are talking in tongues. I never went to those churches. This is a movie that does not understand the end times and does not understand like VR at all. You have much better movies that were written in 1999 and filmed in 1999 and before that. This was done for $5 million and it looks like crap. So the basic premise is it is 3 months after the rapture, which is not in the Bible, by the way. There are certain passages that kind of allude to one of those things, but the rapture in and of itself is like a 1800s, like early 1900s, like, you know, like misrepresentation of what it tries to say. So 3 months after the rapture, there's a messiah that shows up, and he's not in the movie until like the last 10, 15 minutes of the whole thing.
Another act of hatred. The haters have stolen the day of wonders from us.
You see like his face around and whatnot. A bunch of people get raptured and disappeared. The main character is pushing his daughter on a swing set, and then his wife and daughter just disappear and vanish into nothingness. And he's just like, where'd my family go? And he's an agnostic. He used to be a very religious person. And as the movie goes on, you get to learn more and more about him, which is a good way of writing it. Is this a good movie? No, it's like five tops. This movie sucks. Even his attempts at humor, I'm like, okay, whatever. But it's like the 90s, so I'll give it to him.
Well, if God didn't want us to eat animals, he shouldn't have made them out of meat.
Oh, I'm not vegetarian because I love animals. I'm vegetarian because I hate plants.
Those people actually do try. Some people try way too hard in this movie, that's for sure.
Back off, lady. If it wasn't for him, you'd all be dead right now, because if it was up to me, I'd shoot every one of you.
So the Messiah is saying, like, I'm the reason why all the nuclear weapons disappeared. I'm the reason why all those people disappeared. They weren't firm believers. If you want to not be, you know, taken away and vanished, you need to believe in me. Any Christian who says that is, you know, is a Christian, which are called the haters in this movie, which I think is very funny.
The haters are to be considered armed and extremely dangerous.
I don't get it.
They're going to get killed and get, you know, sent to rehabilitation camps. There's one person that like turns his son in. You're like, oh, it's because he's gay. Like, no, he found him like on his knees holding a Bible or whatever. I'm like, that's fucking weird.
Last night, I found a Bible in his room.
Dad, I was praying for you.
You've done the right thing, sir.
There's this one guy who's kind of a demonic, or he's the messenger for the Messiah. Would you be supposed to believe that he's a demon because he walks through walls and he can't be hurt?
Drop that weapon now!
I'm here to help rid the world of anyone and everyone who stands in his way.
So the plot happens with them driving to a murder scene where like somebody's blowing up a school bus full of like kids. And they're like, ah, those damn Christians. Oh, excuse me. Ah, those haters. They blew up a school bus full of kids. We need to take them down. Granted, it's been 3 months and everybody's changed their mind on like what a Christian is. And like, they're the haters. They're the evil ones. Press X to doubt.
You know, ever since we're little kids, you never believed in anything. At every puppet show, you're looking for strings. Finally, you got all the proof you need and it's still not good enough.
Maybe I'm not looking for God. I'm just looking for my family.
And so they track down these people because of like a, they find like the bomb device is like has a tracking element in it. So they track that down. There's some people just doing a Bible service in a warehouse.
The command that detonated that bomb came from this very building.
Well, maybe the detonator was on a timer, not the bomb. Maybe somebody just placed it in here long before these people got here.
They want to go in guns a-blazing, but like the main character's like, no, calm down. Let's just go talk to them. They're probably not harmful. Nothing's going to go wrong. They want to shoot him up so bad. And he's like, ah, get out of here. Yeah. And his partner's like, you don't believe in the Messiah. That's your problem. Don't worry. It gets weirder.
They've seen the same thing as the rest of us. Every nuclear weapon on Earth gone. Millions of people vanishing into thin air. If Makaloso is not God, then who is he?
And so one of the people hands him a CD with a virtual reality tape on, or, you know, like program on it or whatever. And he's like, ah, I don't know how to work this. I need to take this to somebody who knows.
Because of this.
Well, they go back into search because they hear a noise. And then they find a bunch of dudes with like machine guns for some reason who weren't there like a second before. And then so they gun them down. Then this devil guy shows up and then he shoots them. But Jeff gets saved because he has like this the tracking device that they had, and it like stops the bullet. Then he's sitting in his car, and you see that like all these alien things. So he thinks that the Messiah is an alien, and not anything to do with God, because he has nothing to do with God.
I'm not looking for God. I'm looking for my family.
Maybe I'm not looking for God. I'm just looking for my family.
Takes a CD to the this wheelchair-bound hacker who is like, oh, man, I created this program. Oh, this is crazy. Jeff walks in on the hacker guy, and he's in there with his VR headset. He has no hand controls or nothing. It's just this VR, like they took a virtual boy and just smacked it to his head, which is kind of what it looks like. It looks very heavy.
Thorold Stone.
A friend of Nudes. That's funny, because I heard you killed him.
I'm sure that's not the only lie you heard today.
So Jeff walks in with to see this wheelchair guy with a big VR goggles on, waving a gun around. And you know, later on, they're like putting lotion on. He's like, let me show you something. Let me show you this beach and this VR set. Look at all these things that are around you. This one beach, this one corner of the beach. And then he picks up a seashell and then he like cuts himself with it. And then he like, take off the VR headset. And he's like, oh, see, nothing actually happened. I'm like, you don't understand how like VR works. That's for damn sure.
Hey,
I'd show an example, but I don't have a VR headset currently. The hacker guy calls up the devil guy. He's like, hey, I got somebody here with this CD. I gave him the wrong password. And he doesn't, you know, he has no idea what's going on. He's sitting right there. So they get like tracked down by the evil corporation, the One Nation Earth, also known as the One, which is so stupid and redundant. And they have to go find the hacker's sister. Now, the hacker, to be more clear, like he is in league with the devil guy. He believes the Messiah is the Messiah and who he says he is. His stepsister is a British woman who's in charge of all the Christians, and they're all underground.
It might be a bigger organization, but we only really see like four of them.
And like has to keep all things hush hush.
Where are they? Over there.
What, are you crazy? They can't be over there. They find him immediately. It's fine.
How you doing, sis?
Oh, the news said you were killed by some crazy lunatic.
Alan, come on. You gotta know better than anyone else not to believe everything you hear on television.
And there's another girl who's there who's kind of more cynical on Christianity itself. She's like, well, just because you walk into a church, you know, makes you just as much as a Christian as you walk into a pet store and you become a cat.
Please, going to church makes you about as Christian as going to a pet store makes you a cat.
The interaction between the hacker and the blind woman is very funny. Like, they actually have a decent rapport back and forth, and it's kind of nice.
They have terrible jokes, but they do have a nice rapport.
Then they decide, well, okay, we need to figure out what's on this thing. We need to figure out what's on this disc.
And the Day of Wonders is the main driving force for the mystery of the whole thing. Like, what is the Messiah's Day of Wonders? What's happening? Oh, it's on this disc. What is it? We're putting it on VR goggles. What's in it? I don't know. Blank wall.
Let's see what all this fuss is about. Whoa!
He has to, Jeff starts explaining like why he doesn't believe in God anymore. And it's because like he had his mother was dying of cancer and she was like, you know, like wasting away. And he's just praying for God to help out. And it's like, you know, like heal my mother and whatnot.
And when the pain was so much that she couldn't pray. Well, I prayed for the both of us, prayed night and day. You know what I saw? I saw anguish.
And she's still wasted away. So he's like, what's the fucking point? I'm not looking for God. I'm looking for my family. Where did everybody go? And why is this mysterious man, you know, taking people? And where has he put them?
There is no God.
We keep cutting back and forth between like the Christian group and the devil man. And he's kind of torturing one of the Christian women. And it's like, you need to deny God. If you deny him, then like you can let us in and like the Christianity will be over with. And I'm like, you don't understand humans, first of all. We're very stubborn. I mean, he shoots his light. He's like, takes the daughter away, supposedly kills her or does other horrible things to her and then kills her.
Don't you see you've lost? You've lost. God's lost. You won't have anyone to come back for. That's what the Day of Wonders is all about. Renounce him. What's wrong with you?
And like shoots the like her husband right in front of her and just like, you need to deny everything. I didn't expect an Inquisition, but there you go.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Because she will not relent. The Christians find out about that. So they decide, well, the only way we're going to get into this thing and like destroy what's happening is to write a virus code and then upload it at their main facility to stop this worldwide, you know, phenomenon that's supposed to happen. Then we cut to like him doing a terrible like walking in like I'm supposed to be here today. Hi, Bob.
How you doing?
So as he gets further into there to try to upload this virus, the blind woman actually puts on the VR headsets, and then the Day of Wonders happens.
But today is the Day of Wonders. Everything that you see is real.
Now the VR headsets, I should explain. When the devil is in charge, or Satan, whatever you want to call him,
when the Day of Wonders takes over, when it's activated is what I'm trying to say. When you're in that thing, real things are happening to you. In this movie, if you die in VR, you die in real life.
All illusions have been shattered.
So it's like you get cut. You die. You know, like you're restrained, which is not how VR works at all. And the hacker guy even makes the claim. It's just like, oh, it's just this one line of code. I'm like, that's not how that works. He goes on to explain that like the seashell that he cut himself with was like, you know, thousands of lines of code. But he's just missing this one line of code that like turns virtual reality into actual reality, which gives you like, you know, like supernatural powers or whatnot, or can transfer supernatural powers from the Messiah. And she puts on the glasses and can see again. And then becomes a believer and gets like marked with the beast, the 666. She comes back and is like gets ropes the guy in the wheelchair, the hacker guy, to put on the headsets, and then he can walk again. Although they don't show that part, they just show it to where like he's holding a gun at his sister and stands up really quick, and you know, he starts, you know, talking shit, and he's like, you need to be destroyed and all this whatnot.
God, no.
Oh God, yes! Put it down!
Jeff finally gets into the main area to upload the thing. He gets a phone call from the hacker guy. He's like, hey, you got to put on the headset before you can like upload anything. And at the same time, the sister's trying to back away because she kind of figures out what's going on. There's a slight little gunfight. And then Satan basically makes him shoot his own dog. The bastard.
Good doggy.
She gets away. And then her friend shows up.
What's going on?
Get back in the car.
I believe he's another cop who's like an infiltrator in the O&E. They go to the headquarters with her in handcuffs for some reason because like, I caught her. Yeah, just let me go in. And then they're trying to find Jeff. Jeff is locked in there with the representation of the Messiah inside of a white room with no curtains.
Hey, some curtains would be nice.
The Messiah's like, oh, you just believe in me. I can give your family back or whatever. Look at all these miracles around. I'm like, it's just a fucking white room, dude. Is that a guillotine? Like, this is the Day of Wonders. This sucks. And like the family's over there like, huh, we need to come here. And Jeff asks his wife, he's like, well, what about eternity? What are we going to do about eternity?
You just open your heart a little. We're talking about eternity here.
And she doesn't say anything because she's a very devout believer.
And what about the rest of eternity?
And he's just like, oh, also you're full of shit. Okay, no. Like, I believe in God, but I won't believe in you ever.
You're not about love.
So the Messiah straps him to this guillotine, big cross guillotine. He makes a nice little speech, and he's like on his deathbed, he's like, you know, like I'll do whatever I can, but I'll never praise you, that whatnot.
Lord, I did honor you with my life. By your grace, may I do so in death.
And then right as he's about to get killed, the stepsister shows up. In order to get Jeff out of the VR headset, the cop shoots one of the computers, which he wasn't connected to anyway.
Well, it was the only one with the display on, so I guess that's the one.
Just shoots one of the computers. And then they're like, oh man, we need to find a different one to use. She's like, oh, that one.
Because the program was written on a CD, but they're trying to upload a floppy disk. Yeah.
So they upload the virus. It's going really slowly. The devil guy catches up to him, puts all the other characters, and then puts them in this like bio incinerator, and it's gas oven. We're getting very Nazi vibes at this point.
Let's see if they can sing and scream at the same time.
Because it's hard to sing with your mouth full of flames.
Because they start singing gospel hymns, and then he keeps cranking up the heat more and more and more and more. You only see like the flames and whatnot. And he's just like, no, no, he's saving them, no.
It's him. He's protecting them. Turn it up more.
The hacker guy runs into the computer room. How he got there so fast, I don't know.
Maybe it's like Neverending Story 2, where the darkness moves faster than the light.
And he starts smashing up checking all the computers, trying to figure out which one it is. I don't know why they just turned the damn like the screen off. I don't know. He finds out which one it is, takes the disc out, smashes the TV, but it doesn't go out. It's not even plugged in, but it's not out, and it's still uploading because God.
This is impossible!
And then, like, the whole place blows up all the hell. The movie ends with a speech from the Messiah from, like, a balcony or whatnot. And it's telling them, oh, we're going to get him. We're going to get him next time.
I'll get you next time, Gadget.
Don't worry. You know, like, the Day of Wonders, like, we can bring it back. We can do it again.
Damn you, Jesus.
The haters have stolen the Day of Wonders from us.
So yeah, that's Revelation. Do I believe in Revelation? No. Didn't I ever explain all these things that are just on my floor annoying the crap out of me? Look at all this. I just threw them on the ground. I was hanging out with my grandma recently, so like a lot of this has been on my mind, and also a lot of like YouTube stuff I've been watching is about like the deconstruction of religion or Christianity specifically. I don't know, like, was I ever a true believer, if you want to like say that? Yes, I was. I was an absolute believer at one point in time. I used to have nightmares, where I'd have to sleep on the couch in the living room just to be closer to people because, like, you know, that sermon about God just, like, you know, and devil and all that crap, like, freaked me out. I'm like, am I a bad person and all this kind of whatnot. And, you know, I was like, how do you come out to your family? No, you don't. He's kind of just like, yeah, whatever. I'm not going to deal with it. By the way, I also kind of like dudes. I'm kind of like saloon doors. Goes kind of both ways. So yeah, that's it. 5. It's not a good movie. It's kind of entertaining. Like if you see it on like TV, it's just like, nah, this is going to be like, you can put it in the background. It's fine. I don't find anything like actually offensive. Is it evangelistic? Of course it is. It's a religious movie by Jack Venom P and some other people I don't like. When you wake up in like in the morning, and it's like your dad set the DVR to like record. Like, I don't want to hear, you need to wake up and praise Jesus, boy. You guys are a fucking book club. That's all it is. You're just trying to help each other. And like if that a book like that actually helps you, cool. Okay, like so this dead dude, like he was dead, and then like we went to go find him, and then he wasn't there. But then he like came back, and he was like alive, and then he like sent it into the sky and whatnot. Do you have any proof of this? Jimmy told me. Jimmy told you? Okay, Jimmy's reliable. I gotta believe it then. He's just like, don't eat from this tree. Shit, they're gonna eat from that tree, aren't they? Yes, they are. And then you got mad at him for eating the fruit from the damn tree that you didn't tell them what was right and wrong because they didn't know what was right and wrong because you didn't teach them what was right and wrong before they ate the damn fruit. And then you kicked them all out. You're like, no, you disobeyed me. I'm like, yeah, that's what a good dad does.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
I'm rambling. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being here. Please be safe out there. And I will have something else, hopefully for Halloween. Be safe out there. And I'll see you beautiful motherfuckers in the next one. All right?